We're doing sheepy time, sheepy time.
Are you ready? Y'all ready for this? Why are you wearing a sweater? It's so hot.
Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Foster the Meeple, a channel all about
board games
and
board gamey things.
Exactly. And if that's something you're into, then you've come to the right place.
Have they?
Yes. My name is Jamie.
I'm Jeff.
And we're here today to do another overview and review. And today's overview and review,
What are we talking about?
Well, it's in the title, so it's not really a surprise, but that is Sheepy Time from AEG. We were sent this game from AEG to do a review, so thank you to AEG for sending this along. We're just gonna jump in.
Are we?
To the overview. Sheepy Time. You are the dream sheep, the sheep that people count in order to drift off to dreamland. Each time you jump the fence, you help everyone fall asleep easier. But beware the nightmares that haunt these dreams and threaten a rude awakening. Play your cards right, use your Z's on the sweetest dreams, and prove you are the dreamiest sheep of all.
Boom.
Doesn't that sound nice?
Do you know what's funny?
What?
You said Z's, not Z's.
Well, okay, yeah, I know, but when
because it doesn't apply. Canadian Z doesn't apply when for
the Did you catch some Z's last night or what?
Sounds like a surfer.
Yeah, exactly, bro.
Hey, bro, did you catch some Z's? Do you like my hat?
Yeah.
Max from Table Knots sent me this Lord of the Board hat. And if you haven't seen Lord of the Board,
check him out.
Check him out.
And check out Table Knots.
Sam is amazing. And check out Table Knots. But Max sent me this hat because it didn't fit his big noggin. And I have a little baby noggin.
Mm-hmm.
Let's talk sheepy time.
Let's talk sheepy time. So part of the overview I would like to mention is just kind of like how the game works. This is a racing game.
Push your luck.
It's a push your luck race game where each person is a dream sheep and you're trying to outrun the nightmare.
Mm-hmm.
There are three different nightmares that come in the box. There's like a wolf, bump in the night, and a spider, basically.
Yeah.
And they all have different types of movement. So you're kind of going around the board and you're hopping a fence.
Yeah, it's this tiny little rondelle that you just kind of keep going around.
The push your luck aspect is you're trying to, once again, outrun the nightmare, but you don't know how fast they're going to move. Mm-hmm. You don't know if they're going to land on your space. So you can get around the board and then make a decision of whether or not you're calling in a night or you're going to push your luck and try and go again.
Go another time around.
Which can be very, very risky.
A full rotation around to jump over the fence. You have to make a decision of whether you're going to stop or continue.
Mm-hmm.
And once you make that decision, it's finalized and you do the thing. So if you end and decide to call it a night, you score your points, and that's the end of your round. But the nightmare can either catch you two ways. It can land on your space twice and knock you out. Or if it gets a full rotation on the rondelle and jumps the fence itself, then you also...
You wake up.
Wake up and don't score points, or don't score as many points, kind of do.
And there's like different tiles that lay around the board that get added each round. So there's also an element of tile drafting a bit.
Yeah.
And you lay those on the space, and then when you land on that space, you, if you have any Z little markers on it, then you can gain access to that benefit or that action. That is just a very general overview. There are many people who have gone through full how-to-plays and playthroughs, and I will be sure to link some of those down below. Let's jump into the theme.
When I saw this, I was like, yep. This makes perfect sense for Jamie. This is going to be Jamie's type of game. I thought it was going to be a super kind of friendly, fun kid game.
Cute game.
No, that is not what is in this box.
It's not, yeah.
It is cute. It is a very
cute. Technically, you can play it with children. It's 10 plus.
But
this is not a kid's game.
It is a full-fledged push your luck game.
And it can get mean.
Mean not so much as there's like a take that action, but mean as in like if you end and decide to call it a night and someone might be far ahead enough to think that is a strategic way to win in the final round. But then you have someone else who's like, well, I'm going to lose. I might as well just continue to push my luck as many times as I can because there's no way I'm going to win anyway. That person might decide to do that actually come back and win the game. That could happen to you. I'm just saying. I'm not saying it happened to us. I'm not saying that happened to me specifically. I'm saying it could happen to you.
Right. Anyways, the theme. So the theme is basically your sheep, like we said, trying to outrun a nightmare.
Yeah.
It is a very cute theme.
Very cute artwork.
The artwork is so, so cute. I really like the idea and the theme that is like specifically like you're trying to outrun a nightmare. And, you know, you always, when you think about when you're a kid, like you can't fall asleep, so you count sheep.
Yeah.
The theme is very cute.
Just to your point, I really like that concept of outrunning the nightmare. Because, like, in my experience, when I have a nightmare, you realize you are, and then it's like, I'm trying to wake up. Like, get me out of here so I can wake up.
And the actual nightmares themselves are really fitting to the theme because they are things that typically you would have a nightmare of when you're, like, a little kid. Like, the bump in the night, which is basically, like, the thing that hides under your bed. Or, do you remember that old show, Bump in the Night? Anyways, it was on my TV.
Yeah, like spiders.
Spiders is another one, and like werewolves and stuff like that. Yeah, so,
like very kid-esque things that you would be scared of.
Yeah. So overall, I think the theme is great. I've never played a game this theme before. I've never played a game that has sheep in it. Well, that's a lie. There's tons of
games with sheep.
Okay, but...
but normally as a resource, not as a meeple.
You're the sheep.
Speaking of the meeples.
Well, we'll get to that in components.
Oh, right. I'm not allowed to skip.
Yeah. Which we may as well move on to now. So components.
Oh, so you can segue into components.
Well, I know the plan. Components. Do you see this? How thick that is. How shiny the paper. It starts off with a beautiful rule book with very high quality paper.
Oh, God.
Stunning.
Two new viewers. I'm going to say this every time. Jamie has made this a point of mentioning every time that she loves the paper.
Unless there's a game that has crappy paper. In the box, you get a board, you get a scoreboard.
That helps.
And, well, this is the board that you actually, like, run around. And there's a little fence that sits on the board, and that is the fence that your little sheepies jump on. In terms of quality, it's pretty strong, sturdy cardboard.
I love this nightmare meeple.
It comes with... four player token meeples, which are these little sheepies, adorable. So there's four, you could play up to four players. And then like Jeff just mentioned, there's also the nightmare meeple, which is real scurry. There's also a lovely first player token with this cute sheep with his little bear.
First sheep.
Like we mentioned before, there are tokens that go around the board and they are just cardboard well. But the cardboard's really good quality.
They kind of slot perfectly too. Like as the game progresses, you'll put these next to spaces which allow triggers to happen and they kind of just fit perfectly around the board.
And then of course you have cards. So there's within these cards, they're movement cards. So each card will tell you you can move so many spaces and or you can gain so many winks. And winks are how you score. So every time you get a wink of sleep, you move your little token on the score marker up one. And the whole point is you're trying to get your score marker over your little pillow.
This is an interesting dynamic in this game. To score, you have two different things. You have your winks that are kind of going this way, for example, and then you have your pillow, which is down at the bottom going this way. In order to win, you actually have to have them intersect and overlap each other. And that happens through certain triggers.
So you have the sheep cards for the movements and the winks. Some of the cards will also have movements and catch one Z. And the Z token, like we said before, is what you put on the little cardboard pieces that allow you to actually use them. So there are two types of Z tokens. There are ones that you actually remove. And when you remove it, you can use it.
Mm-hmm.
You're catching some Z's right now.
I'm catching some oxygen in my yawn.
And then the Z tokens flip over and it's an infinity Z. And if you have one of those on the tiles, then you can use it every time you land on it without having to pay for it. There are also nightmare cards. And the nightmare cards look identical to the sheep cards on the backside. As soon as you pull a nightmare card, you have to do whatever it says immediately. So as an example, this one says the nightmare jumps two spaces forward. That would be its movement. Some of them go backwards. You know, there's all these different things that they can do.
The nightmares all have different movement capabilities depending on which one you choose to play with.
Cards are really good quality. The art on them is great. Then you also get your three nightmare cards
Carriage. It's cards.
It's your card.
Which tell you a little story about the actual nightmare. So as an example, the nightmare wolf says, "That nightmare wolf is no big deal. Three eyes and still doesn't see us sneaking past. Nope, definitely not scary at all. Dot, dot, dot. Ooh." The wolf is right behind me, isn't it? Which I think is pretty funny.
Yeah.
And then on the back, it tells you what all of the wolf's cards do. So you get one for each of the nightmares.
I really enjoy when companies add a little, or publishers add a little bit of flavor text.
Yeah,
even when you don't, like, they didn't need to add that in.
No, and a little bit of humor.
Yeah, just a little bit of something. Even if it's just like, I want to read this when it's not my turn.
Exactly. These are also included, and these are how you tell how to move your pillow.
How to how.
They tell you how to move your pillow.
How to how.
A 3-player side, 4-player side, 2-player, and you can play this solo as well.
Oh, so neat. I didn't know that.
Yeah, I played it solo. And this is the wink. I will do a close-up. But this is your score marker token. It's just like a head. And I think like the point is you're trying to get your head onto the pillow.
Mm-hmm.
So there's 4 of those, 1 for each player. And then the last thing that comes is just a bag full of little tokens. And you have pillow token, so each player gets a pillow token, and you have your Z tokens. So there's a pile for each color. One side says Z, and then the other one is a Z infinity.
Ugh.
Cat hair. It also comes with cat hair. JK, that's just from our house. Components are really, really high quality.
Yeah, I mean,
the one thing that I've heard some people have an issue with, which was not an issue for us, is the font choice that they used. Could definitely be very difficult to read for some people, especially because as you're adding, like Jeff mentioned, you add these pieces around. If it's upside down to you, it might be a little bit harder to read.
I think that's pick and nits.
I think it is.
I think there's many, many, many games that have way worse text and font choice than this that I've never heard complaints about.
And the box itself, there's a place for everything, so everything fits in nicely. And I love the artwork. I love the meeples.
Yeah, the
aesthetic is very me.
Definitely very you.
What about rules? Now, I read the rule book. You didn't read the rule book.
As per usual.
It was very easy to understand.
It's very big.
It's very big. So, and not just like, it's big because the writing
I meant like blown up.
Exactly. Yeah, it's super easy to understand. It's written very simply. They give examples all throughout. It's like, hey, if this happens, this happens. They also give different variants of play, solo rules, and all that stuff.
I would say you taught this to me in under 10 minutes.
Yeah.
Mind you, we're getting better at learning games quickly with how many games we've played. But I would argue that new to the hobby, people also would not have a difficult time learning this. It's very straightforward.
Oh, yeah. I think you could
draw cards, move around the rondelle,
mm-hmm.
rinse, repeat.
And I would say it's easy enough to learn and easy enough to teach and play that this would be a really good game for non-gamers.
I was going to say that, but I didn't know if that was a good time to mention it since we're in the rule section.
Well, it's easy for newbies to learn.
I think this would be a great gateway game.
Yeah.
I honestly do, and I think we said that when we played it. So yeah, I mean, it says 30 to 45 minutes per play, and it also depends on certain things in the game.
That's a good point. So we're pretty much in gameplay now. So just so you know, we've now transitioned
into gameplay. We've transitioned into gameplay.
But that's a good point because the nightmares that come with it gives you 3, like I said. 2 are classified as beginner.
Mm-hmm.
1 is classified as advanced. So we haven't played with the advanced nightmare yet.
Oh, okay. I didn't know that.
We've played with the 2 beginner level ones. So I'm wondering if it would take longer. Other things about gameplay and replayability. So I've played this solo and then we've also played it at 2. So in terms of a solo game, this is not a game that I would go to play solo. Unless I played it completely wrong, there is no way to lose. So basically you're
just a timer thing. How quickly can I win?
Yeah.
I'm going to win, but how quickly can I do it?
Right. If there's no real risk of me losing, then I'm a little bit less intrigued to play it as a solo game.
What I enjoy is that that companies and publishers are identifying that solo gaming is important.
Yep, definitely.
And games are expensive. So if someone's putting the money into buying this,
mm-hmm.
and they are in a situation where it's like, I have only a few games.
Mm-hmm.
I'm alone. I want to play a game. At least it's an option.
Yep.
Even if it's not like the best option
or
for a solo game.
If you're just getting into solo games,
sure.
Then this would be a great one to see if like, hey, yeah, I do like to play by myself.
Mm-hmm.
Other gameplay?
I don't enjoy Push Your Luck. Quax is something that comes to mind that I don't overly enjoy. It's growing on me. I don't know what it was about this one that I didn't mind the Push Your Luck piece.
I think it's because it has the race aspect, which we've really been enjoying, I think.
I find I get more frustrated when it's an actual Push Your Luck pull a thing out of a bag.
You don't like bag builders.
I think that is the component that I don't enjoy as much.
And you have options with your cards.
I have options with cards to play. Where a bag builder is like, I'm pulling one token and I'm stuck with that. And I have to play it. Whereas this, I have a hand of three cards. Yes, it's Push Your Luck, but I can kind of strategically make a decision on what I want to do next. I think that's what puts this a bit above.
Mm-hmm.
We had a lot of fun playing this.
Yeah, I wanted to play
it
immediately after.
A lot of good interaction between the two of us.
I got really mad.
Again, we are very competitive. The amount we laughed playing this was actually kind of surprising.
It's a good point. There's a lot of interaction with this game. This isn't like, okay, I'm just doing my own thing. You're really kind of like, what's he going to do?
Yeah, and it's
like,
not
is he going to go around again?
It's not necessarily interaction in-game either. Like,
no.
It's just that mental interaction that I enjoyed. Like, okay, he's two spaces away from jumping over the fence. Is he going to keep going?
Yeah.
I don't know. Maybe he will.
Right.
And then you have that kind of like, well, what are you going to do? What are you going to do?
Yeah.
Like, I had a ton of fun playing this.
And in terms of replayability, I think there's a ton of replayability value here. Number one, there's a lot of space left in the box. So I'm assuming they're going to do some expansions. The amount of tiles that you get, you can't go through all of them in one game and you shuffle them up every game. So you're going to have way more options.
Mm-hmm.
Because it has that element of Push Your Luck race game, I think that just generally gives it a lot of replayability.
Mm-hmm.
And I really do hope that
they're gonna
bring out some more nightmares.
I would be shocked if they didn't. I do think this game would play well in a group that just want to have some fun and laugh and not care too much and just have a good time.
Yeah. So any critiques for the game or even thinking about who this game might not be for? People who hate Push Your Luck.
Yeah, Push Your Luck. If you are into super heavy Euro games, I mean, this is not going to be your thing. I do wish the three nightmares does seem like not enough.
Not enough. Yeah, I wish the base game came with more.
Even like a couple more options, I think would be great. That would be my one concern, and that kind of ties in with replayability.
Mm-hmm.
If you've played the nightmares enough, you're going to be like, eh.
Yep. The writing style on it as well, like I mentioned before, not an issue for us, but definitely something that I've heard a few people mention. But other than that, I don't really have any critiques other than I just wish that there was more that came in the base game in terms of nightmares.
Yeah.
I love Push Your Luck games and I love racing games. So
it's
adorable.
Combo.
So I'm just like, I'm into this. And then final thoughts. I think we've pretty much covered it all here.
Yep.
I really like this game. I'm excited to play it with more people. I'm excited to play it with like Jason when he comes up. And I think this is going to be one of the games that when we're just kind of like having a chill day, it's like, what do you want to play? I know myself well enough to know that this will be one of the games that I'm like, do you want to play Sheepy Time?
When we do our game days, we like to start light, you know, like in the morning, have a coffee, have breakfast and play a game. This would be one that we would likely turn to.
Yeah.
I think final thoughts are, don't judge this. If you're like me, don't judge this by its cover and its artwork.
Mm-hmm.
I think you would have a ton of fun with it. If you like race games and you like Push Your Luck, it's a no-brainer.
And if you like things that are cute. And also, I'm realizing as I'm like just kind of looking around, I really, really like AEG games. Like Tiny Towns is AEG. What else is AEG?
I really like AEG games.
Well, I really like Tiny Towns.
You saw Tiny Towns and that's what made you think of it.
Yeah. Oh, Space Base is AEG. We love space. Espace. Oh, Mariposas. We really like Mariposas.
Calico.
I'm
we haven't
so excited.
Got yet. That's waiting for us at the Boardroom Game Cafe.
The
we
Boardroom
have to go
Game
pick it up.
Cafe.
Space Base, you love.
Space.
Dice City, you love.
Dice City.
What AEG does well is nail Jamie's theme trigger.
Yeah, I don't think that I've played one that I haven't liked yet.
Like artwork, game, mechanics.
If you're
into
the games that I'm into, I feel like AEG is a good publisher for you. So that is all that we have for you guys today. A little bit about Sheepy Time. This game is available right now, and you know a great place where you might be able to find it?
I bet you I could guess.
I think it's at your friendly local game store.
Indeed.
And for us here in Halifax, that is the Boardroom Game Cafe, downtown Halifax.
So Barrington Street.
On Barrington Street. If you live here, if you're interested, they are now open again for retail.
Yes.
And you can still order online as well. And you can find all their information right here.
Yes, here.
Let us know down below if you've tried Sheepy Time or if you're excited to try Sheepy Time.
Or if you have questions about it.
Yep. We would love to know. If you like what you see, please subscribe. Don't forget to hit that thumbs up and the bell notification button if you want to just always be reminded of when to see our faces. We post every Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday morning. And don't forget to follow us on social media on Instagram and Twitter. We are at Foster the Meeple. And Jeff loves to tweet, so get all up in there.
I'm still learning Twitter. Usually I just peruse the news.
He searches for the hot goss.
The hot gossip.
Thank you for watching. We hope to see you again soon. And now we say
goodbye.
Goodbye. Goodbye!
Later days.
Later days. Sheepy time. I was just waiting for you to interrupt me. Hello.
Ha!
Hello, everyone.
Wait.
Stop. I can't.
Okay, I won't do it. We don't have our notes. Like the order we have to talk about. Oh my goodness, I need that.
Okay.
Do we have any chips?
I'm not bringing chips down there.
I'm so hungry, I didn't eat breakfast. Ugh, it's so nice out. Sunny, warm. I'm in this cold basement dungeon, talking about Sheepy Time, singing Free Willy songs. Hold me. River Jordan. Did we get sent this?
I was just about to say, we got sent this gift. Always. What?
Nothing. You're a nerd.
Why?
Nothing. Keep going, dork. It's a term of endearment for me.
Right.
Yeah. Why'd you look down here? What do I have on my face?
Just judging you fully. But beware. The nightmares that haunt these dreams and threaten a rude awakening. Did that make sense? But beware, the nightmares that haunt these dreams and threaten a rude awakening. They wrote it weird. It's not me. But beware, the nightmares. Oh, it's just my inflection.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, one more time.
You're emphasizing
one
the wrong.
One more time with feeling.
Oh, God.
Sheepy time. You stop. Don't laugh. Let me get
Okay. I made a joke way back in one of the other videos that she's like a representative of Dunder Mifflin.
Dunder Mifflin, this is Pam.
If you don't get that reference, then
Dunder Mifflin, this is. A great
ask Jamie how much she likes Huey Rosenberg games.
I like Patchwork.